Hey everybody, and welcome to the world of SETI. In your search for extraterrestrial life, you will eventually stumble upon this alien life form. When you discover it, all you have to do is watch this video and you'll get all the background information you need for it, as well as how to set it up and play it. So Oumuamua, the first known interstellar visitor to zip through our solar system, has fascinated scientists and stargazers alike. This cigar-shaped 400-meter-long object sped by us in 2017, traveling so fast that scientists deduced it could only have come from another star system. There have been many theories and hypotheses about its origin, and close inspection could have reshaped our entire view of life in the universe, but sadly, Oumuamua left our solar system a little too early. However, in SETI, players have that opportunity. In the game, you can reveal what appears to be fossilized remains of alien organisms embedded on its surface, what we'll call exofossils. Oumuamua comes with these cards, these exofossil tokens, and this tile. When this species is discovered, you shuffle its deck and deal cards to the players who marked the three discovery spaces. Each player gets one card per marker. You keep the deck near the Oumuamua board and you turn the top card face up beside the deck together with these exofossil tokens. Then you place the Oumuamua tile in this space in disk 3 and fill its data slot with 3 data tokens. If for some reason there would be a probe in the space where you're supposed to place the Oumuamua tile, set it on top of Oumuamua and that player gains 1 publicity immediately. The Oumuamua tile is now part of the solar system and you can totally visit it as you do with the other planets and asteroids. So Oumuamua counts as a planet for cards referring to planets, and every time you visit it with your probe, you gain 1 publicity. You can also place a lander or an orbiter on Oumuamua, just as you do for other planets. And as you can see, similarly to Mars, there are extra landing rewards not only for the first player who lands on Oumuamua, but for the first 3 players. And you may also scan it with your telescope and mark signals on Oumuamua's tile. When you mark a signal in Oumuamua's sector, you have a choice. You may either mark it in the sector or on Oumuamua's tile, and this is also what this icon suggests. As you can see here, there is a 1-point and a 2-point reward for placing the first and third markers in the Oumuamua data slot. Like other sectors, Oumuamua gets completed by taking the last data in its data slot. Each player who marked it gains 1 exofossil, as indicated by this icon. But unlike other sectors, no winner is determined here. You just fully refill Oumuamua with data, leaving no markers behind. And then let's have a look at its board. As it happens with all revealed alien life from boards, whenever you need to place an alien life trace, you have the additional option now to place them on Oumuamua's board. Spaces with this icon let you draw an Oumuamua card. You may draw from the top of the deck, or take the face-up card and replace it with the top card from the deck. In the rare case when there is no cards to draw, this symbol has no effect. These cards work basically the same way as normal cards. They count towards your hand limit, they can be tucked for income, you can discard them for the free action corner, but they're slightly stronger and they usually interact with Oumuamua in some way. Some spaces on the Oumuamua species board require you to spend exofossil tokens to mark them, and you want to try to do that as they give you 25 whole points. And to a degree, this is what the species is about, racing to gain 4 exofossil tokens to be able to mark those available spaces. So if you don't have enough exofossil tokens, you cannot mark the space. Exofossils can be gained from placing an orbiter or lander on Oumuamua, from marking signals on the Oumuamua tile, and marking certain traces on the Oumuamua board, and many Oumuamua cards give you the opportunity to gain or use exofossil tokens too. These spaces can be marked any number of times by all players. You need to spend an exofossil token each time you choose to mark it. If you have any questions or if you want to look up some rule clarifications, the Oumuamua rule sheet has you covered, and also there are some rules there specifically for the solo game, so we recommend you to read it. And that was everything you needed to know for Oumuamua. Stay tuned because we have 4 more alien life forms to cover in SETI, so I'll see you in the next video.